Local 12 investigation uncovers wanted felons are avoiding arrest because of a serious flaw in the system.
Yeah, tens of thousands of warrants here in Ohio are not being entered into a crucial system used to catch criminals. And tonight, Chief Investigative Reporter Dwayne Pullman exposes this threat to everyone's safety.
When troopers, deputies, and officers make a stop.
Okay, do you have a license, registration, proof of insurance on you?
Running a background check on the computer.
Looking up people's information, verifying people's information.
1039,
is key to catching criminals.
Pretty much everything that we do comes from this tool right here.
And keeping us all safe.
All right, you're all set. Drive safe.
But this only works if arrest warrants are sent to LEADS, Ohio's Law Enforcement Automated Data System, and NCIC, the National Criminal Information Center. And right now, a stunning number of wanted fugitives from Ohio are missing from these systems.
But as we sit here today, felons wanted for as serious of crimes as murder, rape, domestic violence, may not be entered into the system.
Oh, it's not just may not. Many of them are not being entered into the system.
Ohio Governor Mike DeWine was so disturbed by reports of missing warrants, he formed a task force headed by former Clark County Prosecutor Andy Wilson.
What shocked me was the fact that these warrants for violent offenses weren't being put in the system.
Even more stunning, the actual numbers of missing warrants the task force uncovered. Of 217,052 warrants for arrest issued in Ohio, the task force found only 18,117 were actually entered into NCIC. That's just 8%.
I had no idea how big the problem was.
Even worse, the missing warrants included hundreds wanted for some of the most violent crimes, including 696 for aggravated assault, 358 for sex crimes, and 15 warrants for murder, all missing from the system.
I think the public would be shocked to know that someone can be charged with a serious crime, a rape, a murder, and that warrant is not put into a national database. And that happens.
Boiled down, the missing warrants mean wanted fugitives are invisible when they cross state lines. In 2014, the Ohio State Highway Patrol issued a warrant to arrest 39-year-old Daniel Silkey for felonious assault and resisting arrest. But that warrant was never sent to NCIC. When Silkey moved to Michigan, he avoided capture for 5 years, even though officers there arrested him twice and searched his records on NCIC 55 times. Silkey was finally caught 3 months ago near Toledo when Ohio deputies searched LEADS and found that warrant for his arrest.
You think everybody's looking for this guy and is going to protect you, and you find out when he can cross over a county line, he is now in safe haven and no one can get at him. That's a shocking thing.
The problem? Ohio has 1,076 police agencies and no uniform policy about which warrants to enter. So the governor's task force is recommending that 28 types of warrants involving the most serious crimes must be entered in LEADS and NCIC within 2 days.
They got to do it quickly, within 48 hours.
With that and more than a dozen other recommendations, the governor says he can fix this broken system, but he needs help.
We have started to fix the system. I'm on that. I need the help from the legislature to change the law.
That needs to be corrected.
Ohio Speaker of the House, Larry Householder, agrees with the governor and even wants the warrants entered quicker, within 24 hours. But the speaker insists mistakes and arrests without convictions must be removed from the system just as quickly.
It would have to be entered within 24 hours. Again, if it isn't correct information, it needs to be removed within 24 hours.
While there's no guarantee what will happen at the State House, top leaders in Ohio agree there is a warrant for concern. I'm Chief Investigative Reporter Dwayne Pullman.